What's up, fam, and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me. We are reviewing and reacting to this week's episode of Yajola 99 because, wow, it was very much lit. If you missed it, you are definitely on the right channel. But before we do, please make sure you smash the subscribe button and hit the notification bell. I absolutely appreciate it. So this week, fam, we have this lady by the name of Princess from Matatiele, who is the one who wrote to Ajola 99 because she says that she suspects that her husband is back to his old ways of cheating because he takes his phone with him everywhere he goes, to the toilet, to the shops, you name it. Unlike before, where he didn't have a problem with leaving his phone behind, now it seems like him and the phone is here at root together, amongst other things that make her suspicious of their husband. Okay, she has raised her concerns with the husband, but he ignores her. So of course, Chup Chup will intervene and do what he does best and investigate. And of course, as usual, once you suspect that your partner is cheating, chances are they usually are. So after Chup Chup investigates, he will come with the proof and show Princess that the guy is definitely cheating and he is currently with a side chick. You know the thing with Yajola 99, they always ask you if you want to go and confront your partner now or would you love to deal with the matter privately at home. But then again, after them telling you that your partner is currently with their side right now, I guess one thing that will definitely come to mind is I want to go and catch him red-handed, okay? So of course, Princess will opt for, can we just go and catch him where he is right now, okay? So apparently the husband told her that his cows are stolen and he has to go and search for them in Lesotho. Imagine, that was in the morning when she last saw him. But the proof she's just seen from Ujubjub just shows that Mokai is definitely not in Lesotho, okay? And there is no missing cows. They will of course go and confront him. But then the confrontation takes another route as it gallops out of control. When I say out of control, I mean that he was caught on a horse with his side chick walking beside him. He didn't even offer to give her a lift on the horse, but so immediately when the wife confronts him as to what is going on, he decides to run away on his horse, leaving everyone behind. I mean the side chick, the wife, the crew, everybody, child, okay? This was so funny because of now we see Chup Chup and the crew having to chase after him. Imagine, how do you catch up with a man on a horse unless you run like Caster Semenya? And of course, not a lot of us can, okay? But then to the crew's luck, he eventually falls off the horse flat down on his face. As if that was enough to stop him, he then decides to chase after his horse to a point whereby when Chup Chup keeps chasing him and asking him questions, he takes out his belt and threatens to hit Chup Chup during the people, guys. In the meantime, the wife and the side chick decide to get physical with each other. I don't know why do women love attacking each other instead of the person who double crosses them, but then again, such is life, I guess, okay? When they break up the fight between these two ladies, it turns out that the side had no idea that she is the side chick. To make matters worse, the side chick is saying that she has been with their husband for 2 years, while the wife is saying, I have been with my husband for over 3 years. So basically, all three of them are in a, what can we call it? Entanglement, guys, basically. And they are all from Matatiele. So basically, when the husband is always claiming to be going to Lesotho to take care of business, it turns out that that Lesotho is him visiting his side, who didn't even know she's a side. Hi, the guy was definitely dribbling them. Shame. You know, the sad thing with all of this is that even when the side is trying to explain to the wife that I am no husband stealer, I didn't know that he is married, still the wife wants to fight her. I don't understand why, but then ladies, we can definitely do better on this one. You know, the funny thing about this episode, guys, Chup Chup will always be Chup Chup. There's at this point now we see this, what do we call a princess, the wife, now pulling her panties up because of now she's angry. I don't know if they were falling or not, but then we see Chup Chup saying, mama, pull your panties up, why are you showing us I'm a panty worker on live national television? I but then the wife is furious, is that, hey, I bought these underwears, okay, if I want to show them, they are mine to show off. Imagine. But then she is still continuing to attack the side chick, if we should call her that, okay? If you're claiming that you guys love ready-made men, I've been with this man, you don't know where we come from, we've been through thick and thin, you guys love ready-made men, I will show you. You took the a husband of a wrong person, like swearing and swearing, okay? Of course, at some point the side chick got irritated with trying to explain that, number one, I did not know that I was a side chick, okay? So we are supposed to be pissed at this man, but you are pissed at me. Number two, you keep calling me a husband stealer, Matuba Malapa, as if I've not been explaining this thing to you. But just to spite you, I guess I will just stay with your husband, because of now I definitely know that he is married, and I keep explaining to you that I didn't know, but you're still threatening me, attacking me, so I guess I'll just keep your husband and stay with him, so that now you can definitely hate me for something that definitely exists. While all of this is happening, since the husband left and fled the scene chasing after his horse, we don't know if this time he definitely went to Lesotho for real, because now kushubile kushushu, he has two women he was dribbling who didn't even know about each other. So I guess even the side chick also thought that she is the wife. I wouldn't be surprised if she is also thinking that she's the wife, or the guy definitely also paid lobola for her as well, because wow, it seems like the guy definitely knew what he was doing, okay? Am I saying this? It's because of, it's like, it looks like the guy each time, every week, he'd be like maybe 3 days at the wife's place, maybe another 3 days at the side chick's place, and both of them didn't know that he has two homes basically that he's supporting, because he tells the other when he's not with them that I'm going to Lesotho, because of apparently it looks like he runs a cow business. So when he's with the other one, he tells the other one that I'm not here, I'm not around, I have to go and check on my cattle, my cows in Lesotho, and all that sort of thing. So nje Mugai was definitely running two households, if we may say. So moral of this episode, guys, I still don't believe that there are people who still blame other people when their partners cheat on them. You know, one of those people who will tell you that he or she knew that I was seeing you, but she still decided to be in a relationship with you, as if you didn't know that you were in a relationship with your partner. Or as if, like, I mean, if your partner doesn't feel the need to owe you loyalty, why should I, as the other woman, give you loyalty where I don't even know you? And in most cases, I didn't even know that you exist, okay? So instead of attacking each other, can we just try to be civil about the matter? I know it's hard when your emotions are high and you are angry and in disbelief of what just happened, but attacking another person for your partner's infidelity is just making matters worse, because at the end of the day, in cases like this, that cheating person ends up leaving both of you and finding another person to dribble, while you guys end up staying there and looking like Popeyes. But then again, guys, that is just my 2 cents thoughts, okay? Apart from that, fam, thank you so much for making it towards the end of this video. Please don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up, subscribe to this channel. I love you so much, and I'll definitely see you in my next upload. Cheers for now.
Any time for any gossip now.